Good afternoon and welcome back to Mexicali, Mexico for game number two on this first day of competition at the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championships. I'm Craig Fata. We're so glad you can join us from around the Americas or around the world as we are about to witness this Group A contest between Panama and Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico comes into this game ranked 12th in the FIBA U17 rankings, while Panama is ranked 53rd. Puerto Rico finished in the silver medal position in this tournament in 2019, which was held in San Juan, Puerto Rico. In 2017, they also took the silver medal. And then in the 2017 FIBA World Cup U17, they took the bronze medal. So Puerto Rico looking to upgrade their medal status in this tournament. There you got to look at our game officials for this game. Ricardo Hales from Jamaica, Bruce Grajeda from Mexico, and Canadate New from the Dominican Republic. We'll be getting the starting lineups for both squads in just a moment. Earlier on today, Costa Rica defeated Aruba in Group A, 93-41, as you look at the starting five for Puerto Rico. Going to be Reynaldo Pagan, Omar Benitez, Yaniel Rivera, Alejandro Aviles, and Edir Torres. The head coach for Puerto Rico is Edin Cordero. He is assisted by Javier Colon and Daniel Cruz. In just a moment, we will get a look at the starting five for Panama, coached by Nicanor Rivas. There's the Andres David, Daniel Smartin, Fernando Gonzalez, Emmanuel Perignon, and Sebastian Boquez. Just a couple of moments away from tip-off. First day of five in competition here in Mexicali. Our Group B games coming up later on this evening. El Salvador and the Dominican Republic starting at 5:30 local time. And then the host nation, Mexico, taking on Jamaica at 8:30. Mexico won the gold medal in 2019 in San Juan, and they are looking for a repeat performance here on home turf in 2021. Tomorrow, today's Group A participants will flip-flop. First game of the day tomorrow is going to be at 11:30 local time, Puerto Rico and Costa Rica, followed up at 2:30 local time by Aruba and Panama. Teams taking the floor, and we are just a couple of moments away from tip-off. Again, wherever you're tuned in from, around the Americas or around the world, we're glad you can be with us. My name is Craig Fata. Game coming to you from the Instituto del Deporte y la Cultura Física in Mexicali. And it's going to be Emmanuel Perignon jumping for Panama against Reynaldo Pagan of Puerto Rico. And we are underway. Rivera to his right. Now here's Pagan over left side to Benitez. Three-pointer on the way is up, no good. Here comes Panama back with its first possession. Pass intercepted by Rivera. And here comes Puerto Rico back the other way. Bounce pass inside to Omar Benitez. And Puerto Rico takes the early 2-0 lead. Panama looking for its first points. Oroku picks up the dribble, double team, now gets it over to Perignon. Perignon hands it off. Bosquez left side, back up top now to Gonzalez. He drives, goes high off the glass right side. Might have been partially tipped there, and here comes Puerto Rico as Yaniel Rivera tries the long bounce pass, goes out of bounds, and it's going to be Panama ball. Pressure here from Puerto Rico that Panama easily breaks, and going to the rack is Bosquez. Puts up the wild shot, no good. Puerto Rico back the other way. Here's Rivera, kicks out to Torres, fakes the shot. And now from the opposite side in the corner, three-pointer on the way, just short. Rebound tipped and then controlled by Machore, and it looks like it's going to be a foul on Puerto Rico. That foul's going to be on Alejandro Aviles. A little bit of backcourt pressure here by Puerto Rico. No score yet for Panama. Puerto Rico with just one bucket so far as we are approaching 2 minutes into this first quarter, and another foul here against Puerto Rico. That one's going to be on Reynaldo Pagan. Pass from Bosquez. Tipped out of bounds. Panama will retain possession with 10 on the shot clock. Panama looking to inbound now. Shot clock down to 6. Baseline shot no good. And here comes Puerto Rico running back the other way. Jumper on the way by Pagan, no good. Panama the rebound. This is Machore. He leaves it back for Perignon, and he strokes it from 15 feet, and Panama is on the board. We are tied up at 2. Pagan into the corner, now back out to Benitez. Benitez from 15, and no shot. Looks like a foul away from the ball. So here comes Panama now, looking for its first lead of the game. 7:15 to play first quarter. Shot on the way from Perignon, no good. Rebounded in the corner by Rodriguez. Pull-up jumper from 14 won't go, and it looked like Devion Rivera had his hand on it but could not control it, and it goes out of bounds. That'll be Panama ball. Oroku to inbound, and a little bit of backcourt pressure again from Puerto Rico. Panama, not much trouble breaking it, but Puerto Rico comes away with the steal in the backcourt. Rather, in the frontcourt, their backcourt now. End-to-end action here between Panama and Puerto Rico. Bosquez looking for a crack to get in through the defense, and he gets into the paint and draws the foul. Bosquez will go to the free throw line. Bosquez can't give Panama its first lead of the game just yet. Davion Rivera was called on that foul. Bosquez misses both free throws, and we remain knotted at two. Ooh, that was almost a pass into the backcourt, and yeah, they called it. Rivera caught that in the backcourt. The ball was clearly over the center line. Not sure where his feet were. It looked like he landed in the front court, but the ball was in the backcourt for sure. And so a turnover by Puerto Rico gives Panama another chance to take its first lead of the game. 6.5 minutes to play, first quarter. Bosquez to his left, now back to his right. Gains the elbow, kicks it outside to Machore. He drives, little scoop layup, and I think they're going to get him. Yeah, he caught his own shot, so that's going to be a travel. Machore with the scoop in the lane. Never really put it up toward the bucket, didn't hit anything. And he caught his own shot and tried to go back up. And the official said, no, sir, you can't do that. So now Puerto Rico looking to take the lead back. Torres, his pass just about stolen away. Shot clock inside 10. Good defense by Panama. Long three-pointer on the way. That is no good. Rebound. Rodriguez went for it, but he got bodied off by Panama, and here they come. Pass inside. Good work by Fernando Gonzalez. Can't get the shot to go. Panama saves it. Actually, it looked like Daniel Machore, his foot was on the line as he leapt out of bounds to try to save that ball, and that's going to be to Puerto Rico. 5:42 to play in this first quarter. Puerto Rico scored early, and they have not scored since. Bounce pass to Rivera. It's knocked out of bounds. Puerto Rico will retain possession. 5:31 to play first quarter. Don't forget, coming up at 5:30 local time, El Salvador and Dominican Republic, followed by Mexico and Jamaica at 8:30. 13 on the shot clock, and going up strong is Edir Torres. He draws the foul, and he's going to go to the line to try to complete the three-point play. Looks like they're going to get Daniel Machore on the foul. Good look at Edir Torres. He misses the free throw, and Panama back the other way now. Looking to tie it back up. Bosquez left side to Machore. Actually, they got that foul on Fernando Gonzalez, not Machore. And Puerto Rico looking to extend. Pass out to Rivera, three-pointer on the way, back iron, no good, rebounded by Bosquez. Inside 5 minutes to play first quarter. Screen by Gonzalez, ball into the corner now, shot clock at 10. Three-pointer on the way, blocked. Panama gets it back, blocked again. And I think they're going to get Davion Rivera on the foul there. And Fernando Gonzalez going to go to the free throw line. That was Rivera on the foul. It's a good look at young Fernando Gonzalez, 17 years old. And that second free throw by Gonzalez swished straight through. tied up at four now with 4:40 to play in this first quarter. Baseline shot, no good. Rebounded by Panama. I think that was Perignon on the rebound. Here comes Maciore attacking the basket. Circus layup with the left hand and in. Panama has its first lead of the game with 4:15 to play in this first quarter. Rivera now getting it left side to Yaniel Rivera. Now to Rodriguez. Up top to Catala. He's hounded, and the shot clock will expire. Great defense on that possession by Panama, forcing Puerto Rico into the turnover inside of 4 minutes to play in this first quarter. 6-4 in favor of Panama. Puerto Rico has turned it over a few times here, and now they double Busquez, and now a jump ball called between Busquez and Santos. The alternating possession arrow will keep the ball with Panama as they try to look to extend their lead. Neither team has led by more than two in this one. Going to the rack strong, Andres Oroku, and Panama now up by four. 8-4, 3:35 to play in this first quarter. Rodriguez over to Daniel Rivera, or Devion Rivera, I should say, beg your pardon. His shot no good. Here comes Panama back the other way. Oroku, little spin move, takes it strong to the hole, and he's going to draw the foul. I believe they're going to get Devion Rivera. Joviel Arroyo into the game now for Puerto Rico. As you get a good look at Andres Oroku, free throw short. Panama not shooting very well from the free throw line so far this game. Rivera, the alley-oop. Oh, beautiful play by Puerto Rico. The alley-oop. As Alejandro Rodriguez converts, and it's 9-6 now, inside 3 minutes to play in this first quarter. And an offensive foul call, that time on Fernando Gonzalez. As Puerto Rico can tie it back up with a three. Yaniel Rivera into the front court, gets it over to Arroyo, now on the handoff, back into the opposite corner. Nice ball movement by Puerto Rico. Kick out to Alejandro Rodriguez. He gets it out to Rivera. Shot clock at seven. Catala now outside. Shot's no good. Arroyo fights for the rebound, gets it back underneath. Catala can't get it, but the stuff on the follow by Devion Rivera. And Puerto Rico back to within one, but Panama at the other end converts quickly. That was Andres Oroku. Now the action getting a little bit more fast-paced. As we come up on the two-minute mark of this first quarter, Panama leads 11-8. Three-pointer on the way, Alejandro Rodriguez no good. Rebound by Lionel Alba. Busquez to the rack. That's no good. And then Hamarabas de Leon gets it blocked. Here comes Puerto Rico. Hanger in the lane, and that is good. Yaniel Rivera gets Puerto Rico back to within one. 11-10 Panama. Coming up on 1 minute and 30 seconds to play. Oroku banks in the three-pointer. I don't know if I heard him call bank on that. But Oroku puts Panama back on top by four. 14-10. Now the offense is starting to loosen up a little bit. Long three on the way, and that is straight through. Alejandro Rodriguez scores from downtown. And Puerto Rico back to within one as we come up on 1 minute remaining in this first quarter. Kick into the corner. Another three on the way. That is good. All of a sudden, both teams have it dialed in from downtown. Andres Oroku scores from outside. Panama back up four. Kick out to Rivera. Tries baseline. Backs out. Gets it back out. And now a long two on the way. That rattles out. Rebounded, though, by Yaniel Rivera. He goes up strong. Can't get it to fall, but he does draw the foul, so he's going to go to the free throw line for a pair. Not sure if it was just some early game nerves on both of these teams. As the score sat in low single digits for quite a while of this first quarter, but now both teams seem to have loosened up some on the offensive end. Yaniel Rivera will go to the free throw line here. And his first free throw is good. Yaniel Rivera will turn 17 years old in 9 days on December 17th. Gives himself an early birthday present there with a pair of free throws. Now Puerto Rico trails by just two. 30 seconds to play in this first quarter. After the offenses were stagnant early, it's gotten pretty entertaining. Puerto Rico coming away with the steal. In transition, the bucket no good. The rebound saved nicely, and here comes Panama back the other way. This is Victor Julio. His shot goes off the top of the backboard, and here comes Puerto Rico back the other way, but they turn it over. Now the long three on the way by Julio, and that is good. Victor Julio scores from way outside, and another three on the way. That is going to be short, but the first quarter with a frenetic end sees Panama on top 20-15 as both teams finally found a little bit of rhythm offensively. They found the range from outside, and Panama will take a 5-point lead into the second quarter. This is the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championships, back with second quarter action in just a couple of moments. Welcome back to Mexicali. Game two of day number one of the 2021 FIBA U17 Centro Basket Championships. Panama leading Puerto Rico 20-15. Earlier today, Costa Rica defeated Aruba 93-41. As we look at the scoring so far in this game, Andres Oroku leading all scorers with 11 points for Panama. Victor Julio has three, Emmanuel Perignon with two, Fernando Gonzalez also with two. Perignon to go has three rebounds, I should say, to go along with his 2 points for Panama. For Puerto Rico, Alejandro Rodriguez with 5, Yaniel Rivera with 4, Edir Torres with 2, Omar Benitez with 2, and Devion Rivera with 2 as well. Panama foul, and Joviel Arroyo will inbound. And here comes Yaniel Rivera. Lob inside, and Edir Torres didn't quite see where that pass was going, and then it ended up being a little bit too far above him and behind him, and it sails out of bounds. Panama takes possession, looking to extend this 5-point lead. Pass saved there by Victor Julio. Gets into the corner. Throws up kind of a wild shot. Shot clock wasn't that low. And here comes Puerto Rico into the corner now. Reynaldo Pagan back up top to Yaniel Rivera. Comes the screen by Aviles. Rivera pulls up from about 14 feet. Shot no good. Another rebound for Panama. Coming up on 1 minute elapsed in this second quarter with Panama on top by 5. De Leon tries to get it inside, but the pass deflected and taken away by Joviel Arroyo. Rivera calling the play over right side to Pagan. Now Aviles, shot clock at 7. Stumbling his way through the lane is Torres. He gets it out. Floater on the way with 1 left on the shot clock. No good. Rebound Aviles. He puts it back up. Gets fouled. Ball sticks in between the cylinder and the glass. But Aviles is going to go to the free throw line. Let's see who they call that foul on here. It's going to be on Emmanuel Perignon. Aviles trying to convert his second free throw. And he does. Good look at the young 15-year-old, 6'9". Alejandro Aviles. Expect to be seeing him on the senior team in a few years. And it looks like there was an issue with the shot clock. Yeah, they reset it to 14, should have been 24. Inside now, Aviles, strong to the hole. He draws another foul. This time he's going to try to complete the 3-point play. As Puerto Rico creeps ever closer. That foul also on Perignon. Aviles unable to complete the 3-point play. And so the deficit remains 2. Puerto Rico with the steal. Good defense in the backcourt. Here comes Rivera. Drops it underneath to Aviles. No, beg your pardon. That was Omar Benitez. And he scores to tie the game up at 20. And Nicanor Rivas has seen enough. Panama has seen its lead slip away. And we are tied up at 20. Timeout on the floor. This is the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championship Tournament live from Mexicali. Back in a moment. Puerto Rico has gone on a 5-0 run to start the second quarter here in game number two of day number one at the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championships, and we are tied up at 20. Panama takes timeout to try to stop the bleeding. That shot might have been tipped there, but here comes Puerto Rico back the other way looking for the lead. Beautiful give, unselfish play there as Alejandro Rodriguez gives Puerto Rico its first lead back since midway through the first quarter. And Puerto Rico now on top by 22-20 with 7:40 to play in this second quarter. Panama looking a little disorganized now offensively. They found a good flow in that first quarter, and all of a sudden they find themselves struggling, but there a pretty behind-the-head pass leads to a basket by Fernando Gonzalez, and we're tied back up at 22. Pretty pass was made by Daniel Smatore. Gonzalez inside now to Aviles, and Puerto Rico turns it over. Here comes Fernando Gonzalez, can't get the shot to go. Busquez tips the rebound, and that is up and good for Daniel Smatore. Now Panama back on top, 24-22. Inside 7 minutes to play, second quarter. Rivera calling the play. Rodriguez over in the corner now to Torres. He drives left side, can't get it to go. It sure looked like Fernando Gonzalez was awfully close to that baseline there. Some physical play along the left side leads to a turnover. And Rivera with a pretty lay-in. Tied back up at 24. I have a feeling that's how this one's going to go the rest of the way here. Both of these teams pretty similar as Busquez can't get the shot to fall. Rivera behind the back dribble, loses the handle. Here comes Mature for Panama. It's to the left side, draws a pair of defenders, and now circles back up toward the top. Into the corner. Three on the way for Oroku, and that is good. Andres Oroku hits from downtown Mexicali, and Panama back on top by three, 27-24. Rivera hounded by Busquez, picks up his dribble. In the paint now, shot by Torres, blocked. Goes out of bounds, and that's going to be Panama ball looking to extend this three-point lead. They led by five coming into this second quarter, but Puerto Rico erased that lead in a hurry, led to a timeout by Nicanor Rivas. And Panama seems to have righted the ship. And it looks like Omar Benitez for Puerto Rico has a split lip. So he's going to have to come out to get that tended to. A little bit of backcourt pressure here by Puerto Rico. Panama into the front court with a few seconds to spare. Achore hounded by Pagan. Achore into the paint, gets it to Gonzalez. He goes up, double clutches and scores. Actually, they're going to say no basket. They say Gonzalez traveled. Now left side, here comes Aviles. He's cut off on the baseline, puts up the shot between a pair of defenders, and it falls in. Tough shot there by Alejandro Aviles. And he's going to go to the free throw line to try to tie this one back up with exactly 5 minutes to play in this second quarter. Foul is going to be on Fernando Gonzalez as Aviles completes the three-point play, and we are tied back up at 27. Panama 14 fouls now. Puerto Rico no team fouls here in the second quarter so far. Pull-up jumper on the left side of the free throw line there by Perignon. No good. Missed badly. And here comes Puerto Rico. Kick out into the corner. Arroyo for three. No good. Rebound Panama. Machore ahead to Vasquez. And an offensive foul called on Vasquez. Tried to stop and spin and drew the offensive foul. Good defense there by Sebastian Rivera. 4:26 to play in this second quarter. Two more games on tap tonight. El Salvador and Dominican Republic coming up at 5:30 local time, followed by the nightcap host nation Mexico and defending U17 champion taking on Jamaica. Melendez scores there for Puerto Rico to put them back on top by two, coming up on 4 minutes to play. Three-pointer now from the corner, no good by Gonzalez. Sebastian Rivera running the point, driving right side, kicks it out. Three-pointer on the way from Melendez. That is straight through and good. Melendez gives Puerto Rico a 5-point lead. It's been a 10-point swing since the beginning of this second quarter. Panama led by five. Puerto Rico outscoring Panama 17-7 in this second quarter so far. Drive and dish all the way back out. Achore on the attack. All knocked out of bounds. It's going to be Panama ball with a fresh 14. Catala back on now for Puerto Rico. Oroku to inbound. Machore over to Vasquez. Here comes the screen by Perignon. Vasquez gallops into the lane and loses the handle. Pagan comes away with it up ahead, and then that pass intercepted by Machore. 3-on-2. Little floater off the glass is up and good for Emmanuel Perignon. And Panama draws back to within three. 3 minutes to play, second quarter. Rivera, left side, over to Catala, top of the key. Now a long three-pointer on the way, and that is good. Jose Melendez. I think he shot that one from San Diego. Puerto Rico up six now, 35-29. Rivera into the front court. Now the kick out to Melendez. Another three on the way. That one missed badly right side. Saved by Aviles, but then thrown out of bounds. It'll be Panama ball. 2:22 in the second. Second game of the day. Deuces Wild. Panama set to inbound. Machore to Julio. Here comes Machore. Now Bosquez back to Machore. Into the corner, thought about the three. Back out to Machore. Shot clock at 9. Long jumper on the way, missed badly. Puerto Rico on the attack. Rivera. The run with the left hand, no good, but therefore the putback, Alejandro Catala. And Puerto Rico has it clicking now. Another timeout by Panama. Nicanor Rivas is going to sit his team down and try to stop this Puerto Rico run. 37-29, a minute 54 to play, second quarter. This is the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championship live from Mexicali. Back in a moment. Puerto Rico leading Panama 37-29 with a minute 54 to play in this second quarter. Panama led going into the second quarter 20-15, but Puerto Rico outscoring Panama 22-9 here in the second frame. And looks like they called that a foul rather than a tie-up. Actually, it's going to be a backcourt violation. So Puerto Rico gets it back, looking to extend this lead. Rivera, right side, three on the way. That is up and good. Jose Melendez scoring again from downtown, and now it's Puerto Rico on top by 11. Minute 25 to play, and the wheels have kind of come off here for Panama in this second quarter. They'd found a good flow in the first. But Puerto Rico is clicking from outside and clamping down defensively, making life miserable right now for Panama. Perignon will go to the free throw line. That foul is going to be on Devion Rivera. Perignon's free throw, no good. Second offering by Perignon, straight through. The lead is 10, a minute 10 to play in this second quarter. Sebastian Rivera hounded, but finally is able to get it to one of his teammates. Jose Melendez can't score, but gets the rebound back. Here's Pagan on the drive. Inside now to Rosado. His shot is up and good. Jerome Rosado Jr. gets into the scorebooks. And the lead is 12, 42-30. Coming up on 45 seconds to play. And that's going to be a foul as Jorge Rocha is tripped. I think that's going to be on Sebastian Rivera. 43 seconds to play in this second quarter. Shot clock will be at 14 for Panama. Busquez handing it back to Machore. And that looks like it's going to be another foul against Puerto Rico. It should be on Alejandro Catala. Busquez takes the inbound pass, three on the way. That's a little short, put back no good by Perignon. And here comes Puerto Rico. Rivera jets toward the bucket, throws it up, and draws the foul. He's going to go to the line. seconds to play in this second quarter. Puerto Rico has really put the hammer down offensively. And put the clamps on defensively. Outscoring Panama 27-10 in this second quarter so far. Free throw by Rivera is up and good. Trying to see who that last foul was on. Looks like it was on Sebastian Busquez. And now Panama can't get out of its own end, and Puerto Rico is going to have one more shot, at least one more shot, and extending this lead. Timeout on the floor. 43-30 in favor of Puerto Rico over Panama with 19 seconds to play in the second quarter. This is the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championship Tournament, live from Mexicali, back in just a moment. Seconds to play in this second quarter. Puerto Rico on top of Panama, 43-30. Panama had led coming into the second quarter, 20-15, but Puerto Rico has really turned it on both at the offensive and defensive end. They came away with yet another takeaway. So they will try to get one more bucket before the second quarter is over. Sebastian Rivera, 10 on the clock, 5 on the shot clock. Kick out into the corner, 3 on the way. That's no good. And Panama thought Panama was going to have a couple of seconds. It looked like the shot clock and game clock were off, and that's what they're talking about here. The shot clock sounded, and everybody thought that was the game clock. So that was an inadvertent whistle there. So Panama will have 2.2 seconds to try to come up with something here to cut into this 13-point Puerto Rico lead before heading into the locker room at halftime. Kentish to inbound, stolen away. 3 on the way by Pagan. Off the glass high and no good. And the second quarter is going to end how much of it has gone for Panama. They turn it over to Puerto Rico, giving them a golden opportunity to rack up points. Puerto Rico took advantage in that second quarter. They go into the locker room at halftime leading 43-30. Here in Mexicali. Second half action at the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket Championship Tournament. When we return, Welcome back to Mexicali. It's the 2021 FIBA CentroBasket U17 Championships. Game number two of the day. Puerto Rico on top of Panama by the score of 43-30. Earlier today, Costa Rica defeated Aruba by the score of 93-41. Panama led this game heading into the second quarter by the score of 20-15, but Puerto Rico turned on the jets and outscored Panama 28-10 in the second quarter to build this 43-30 lead. Leading scorer for Panama, Emmanuel Perignon with 5 points, Daniels Machore with 4, Victor Julio with 3, Fernando Gonzalez also with 4. Actually, I beg your pardon, Andres Oroku has 14 for Panama. He's their leading scorer. Leading rebounder for Panama, Emmanuel Perignon with 6. Machore has 3 rebounds. For Puerto Rico, Jose Melendez has 11 points on 4 of 6 shooting. He's 3 of 4 from beyond the 3-point arc. Yaniel Rivera has 8 points. Alejandro Rodriguez with 7. Alejandro Aviles with 6. Jerome Rosado Jr. with 2. Sebastian Rivera with 1. Alejandro Catala with 2. Omar Benitez with 2. Ronaldo Pagan played nearly 9 minutes but did not score. Yoviel Arroyo played nearly 6 minutes but did not score. Devion Rivera, 2 points. Edir Torres with 2 points as well. Leading rebounder for Puerto Rico in that first half, Yaniel Rivera with 5 rebounds. Sebastian Rivera led with 4 assists. Puerto Rico shot 46% from 2-point range, 30% from 3-point range, for a total of 41% from the floor. Panama, meanwhile, 31% from inside 3-point range, 33% from beyond. Panama exactly 50% from the free throw line. Puerto Rico 55%. 25 total rebounds for Panama, 24 for Puerto Rico. Panama's biggest lead of the game was 5 heading into the second quarter. Puerto Rico's biggest lead, 13. That's where it sits now. The lead has changed 4 times in this game. That was early on. Puerto Rico scoring 17 points from turnovers in that first half. Panama with 12. Fast break points about even. Second chance points, 9-5 in favor of Puerto Rico. Points in the paint, largely in favor of Puerto Rico, 26-12. And bench points, check this stat out, 25-3 in favor of Puerto Rico. Last time Panama led was at the 5:13 mark of the second quarter. Puerto Rico tied it up at 27 and never looked back. They outscored Panama 16-3 over the remaining minutes of the second quarter. So that's where it stands. All the numbers, as you would expect, in favor of Puerto Rico. As we ready to play the second half. For those of you just joining us, my name's Craig Fata. Glad you can be with us wherever you're tuned in from, around the Americas or around the world. This is the 2021 Under 17 FIBA CentroBasket Championship Tournament, game 2 of the day. The between Puerto Rico and Panama. Puerto Rico coming into this one ranked 12th in the world in the U-17s. Panama ranked 53rd, both of these teams in Group A. A pair of Group B games coming up later on this evening, El Salvador and Dominican Republic at 5:30 local time. And Mexico and Jamaica at 8:30 local time. So Panama with the first possession of the second half, and they go straight down to Fernando Gonzalez, and he puts the ball in the hole. And that's a good start in this second half for Panama. Poked away there by Perignon, but Puerto Rico gets it back. Three on the way, no good. Rebound grabbed by Panama, and a good start in this second half for Nicanor Rivas' team. ...18-footer is up and good for Emmanuel Perignon, and just like that, Panama has the lead shrunk down to 9. Daniel Rivera dishes it nicely from the paint. That's Alejandro Aviles, and he scores. Here comes Machore, getting away from the defender, driving the right side and laying it in with the right hand. Beautiful take by Daniel Machore, getting the lead back down to 9. 45-36 in favor of Puerto Rico. Rivera has his pass intercepted. Here comes Panama. They don't have numbers, but Machore takes it, leaves it beautifully, and Panama, on the strength of a Sebastian Boquez fast break layup, has cut the lead down to 7, and now Edin Cordero wants timeout. He does not like how Puerto Rico has started off this second half. They led by 13 coming out of the gate, and now the lead is down to 7. 45-38 in favor of Puerto Rico, 8:24 to play. This is the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U-17 Championship, live from Mexicali, back in just a moment. Panama has sliced the lead to 6, 45-38 in favor of Puerto Rico as we come back to third quarter action here in Mexicali. Puerto Rico led by as many as 13 heading into this third quarter. Nice work under the bucket there by Edir Torres. Lost the handle for just a moment but stuck with it. Lead back to 9. Pass intercepted there by Busquez, or rather the pass from Busquez, intercepted by Benitez. And now 3 on the way, and that is up and good. Edir Torres scoring from long range. Lead back to 12. Now the short jumper in the paint is good for Emmanuel Perignon, and he is coming out strong in this second half. 7.5 minutes to play, third quarter. Rivera on the alley-oop, trying to get Benitez, pass a little errant. Benitez was able to save it, and now Alejandro Aviles, his shot won't go. Rebound tipped, taken out of there by Panama. That's Busquez. He has one man to beat. Goes in with the shoulder, lays it up with the right hand, doesn't get the call. I think that's a good no call right there by the officials. Now Puerto Rico back the other way. Double clutch shot up and no good by Omar Benitez, but he will go to the free throw line to try to get a pair the hard way. The lead is 10. Panama had it cut down to 6 just a few moments ago. But a three-pointer by Puerto Rico, and now a free throw. It's back up to 11, pending this second shot by Omar Benitez. That one is good as well, and the lead back to 12. 7-1 to play, third quarter. Kick out to Oroku. Now back to Perignon. To Machore. Shot clock inside 10. Kick out to Busquez. Shot clock at 5. Busquez to Perignon. His 14-footer won't go. Back tapped and then taken by Pagan. Puerto Rico back the other way, looking for their biggest lead of the game. Three-pointer on the way from Torres, and that is good! Adir Torres gives Puerto Rico its biggest lead of the game at 15, 55-40, after Panama had cut it back down to 6. Busquez trying to answer at the other end. His shot won't go. Here comes Puerto Rico. Easy lay-in up ahead by Omar Benitez on the nice transition bucket. And now Nicanor Rivas wants timeout as he saw the deficit that his team had cut to 6 has suddenly ballooned back up to 17. 57-40 with 6:11 to play in this third quarter. Puerto Rico on top of Panama. This is the 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championship Tournament live from Mexicali. Back in just one moment. Back to live action here as Panama looks to stop the bleeding. They had it cut down to 6. Now Busquez, the three-pointer, and that is up and good. Wide open three-pointer. And the lead now back down to 14, 57-43. Sometimes Panama makes it look so easy when they score, and other times it looks like they just have a great deal of difficulty running any kind of offensive set. Rivera now driving right side, pulling up, hanging and hitting. Beautiful shot there by Yaniel Rivera. Lead back to 16. Machore trapped in the corner, getting it out to Perignon. 10 on the shot clock for Panama. Here comes Oroku putting up the long three, contested. And the rebound there by Melendez. Rivera, the nice bullet pass inside to Benitez, but he couldn't do anything with it. Got it outside. Three-pointer was no good by Torres, and here comes Panama back the other way. Oroku thought better of trying to challenge Rivera, so he circles it back around. Now Busquez thought about the three, has it stolen away. Puerto Rico's got numbers. Here comes Pagan, and he lays it in with the right hand. Strong take by Reynaldo Pagan, and the lead up to 18 now for Puerto Rico. Inside 4.5 minutes to play, third quarter, and Nicanor Rivas has to wonder what happened here to Panama. Shot blocked there, and ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Puerto Rico ball. Panama came out in this second half and cut the lead down to 6. Puerto Rico called timeout, Aiden Cordero, and said enough of that. let's get back to what we were doing, and that was dominating. Rivera now, the lob inside to Rodriguez. A little too deep when he caught it. Back up top to Rivera. Three on the way. That's good! Alejandro, or rather, Yaniel Rivera burying the three-pointer, making it a 19-point lead inside 4 minutes to play. Correction, that's a 21-point lead. And now a travel by Panama. Boy, the wheels really coming off now for Panama. I think that has more to do with what Puerto Rico is doing rather than anything Panama is necessarily not doing. Puerto Rico has just gotten very aggressive defensively, challenging the Panamanian shots. That time, though, the steal there by Machore, and he finishes. Nice defensive play and conversion there by Danielis Machore. 3.5 minutes to play, third quarter. Torres thought about the three-pointer, but De Leon closed, and now Panama comes away with it. Machore attacks, and did they signal a carry? What did they signal? Couldn't quite see. Double dribble? Couldn't quite see the official's hand signal. Yeah, that was a double dribble. Nice pass inside from Rivera. The shot blocked. Perignon on the block, and here comes Panama back the other way, but the pass deflected out of bounds. I believe that was Pagan that got his hand on it. No, that was Alejandro Rodriguez. .306 to play. Puerto Rico leading by 19. They had their lead cut to 6 at the start of this third quarter. And that pass tipped out of bounds. 9 on the shot clock. Humberto Kentish to inbound the ball. As Panama makes a substitution. Juan Lewis coming on. Here comes Oroku. Into the corner now. And ball kicked out of bounds. That should be a fresh 24. Beg your pardon, fresh 14. So Panama gets a few more seconds to play with offensively here. And now a couple of more substitutions for Nicanor Rivas. Victor Julio on the court now. And Panama throws it away on the inbound pass. Here comes Puerto Rico. 3 on the way from Rivera. That is good! Yaniel Rivera drills one from downtown, and Puerto Rico has its largest lead of the game at 22-67-45. And looks like a technical foul called. That's going to be on Yaniel Rivera. Did not see what he did, but evidently the officials saw something, assessed him with the tee. Panama scores, and they get the ball back with 2:38 to play in this third quarter. Our game officials doing an outstanding job as always. Ricardo Hales from Jamaica, Bruce Grajeda from Mexico, and Candidate Nu from Dominican Republic. Rivera now into the front court, his team ahead by 21. The kick out into the corner for Catala. He's cut off. Shot won't go. Panama the rebound. Victor Julio grabs it. Up ahead to Kentish. He gets a little too deep under the bucket, throws it up with the right hand, gets the shot blocked, but he hits the deck, and he's going to go to the line. Good attack there by Kentish. Foul's going to be on Alejandro Aviles. Good look at young Humberto Kentish, 16 years old. Confidently strokes both free throws, and the lead down to 19 now, 2:11 to play in this third quarter. Couple of substitutions here as Devion Rivera gets ready to inbound the ball. Gets it to Sebastian Rivera. Three Riveras on the Puerto Rico roster. Catch and shoot, shot blocked on the three-point attempt by Jose Melendez. Puerto Rico gets it back, shot tipped. Good defense by Panama on that possession. Now a three-pointer on the way on the far side, and that is up and good. That is Humberto Kentish. He's on a little mini five-point run of his own. Lead down to 16 now. Coming up on a minute and a half to play third quarter. I think Kentish got a piece of that one, and his feet go out from under him, but Panama retains possession. Lob back outside. And now stumbling into the paint is Juan Lewis. Now into the corner, 10 on the shot clock. Three-pointer is up and good by Lionel Alba. And the lead down to 13 now. 54 for Panama, 67 for Puerto Rico as we come up on 1 minute to play in this third quarter. And now an offensive foul on Puerto Rico. Three ball here, and Panama cuts it to 10. Julio in the backcourt. Picked up by Sebastian Rivera. Gets the screen now, moving to his right. Gets to the free throw line, loses the handle. And the easy conversion there by Sebastian Rivera on the fast break bucket. Lead back to 15, 40 seconds to play, third quarter. Boy, every time Panama's made a run, Puerto Rico has countered. Pretty fadeaway along the baseline there by Juan Lewis. And now the Puerto Rico foul. Going to be on Sebastian Rivera. Pardon, they called the Panama foul on number 25, Emmanuel Perignon. So Puerto Rico retains possession. Yaniel Rivera. Picked up by a trio of defenders, and the ball snatched out of the sky by Hamarabas de Leon. Here comes Panama. And a foul called near the midcourt stripe with 10.7 to play in this third quarter. Boy, if Panama could come away with a three-point bucket here. Actually, Kentish is going to go to the free throw line as Puerto Rico now over the limit. Kentish misses the first free throw. And as you sometimes see when you're short on the first one, a little too strong on the second, and a foul on the rebound attempt against Panama. So it's going to be Puerto Rico ball. Foul is on Hamarabas de Leon. 9.1 to play, third quarter. Yaniel Rivera's got to go the length of the court. Game clock at 3 now. Hounded by Juan Lewis. Here comes Lewis, and he's not going to get a shot off before the buzzer sounds. But a good run by Panama to cut it back down to 13. 69-56 as we head into the fourth quarter. Puerto Rico's lead was over 20 here in this third quarter after Panama had cut it down to 6. We've got an entertaining fourth quarter coming up. This is the 2021 FIBA Central Basket U17 Championship live from Mexicali. Fourth quarter action when we come back. Both teams lit it up offensively in the third quarter as Panama and Puerto Rico each scored 26. And that means Puerto Rico takes its 13-point lead into the fourth quarter, 69-56, as we look at some of the individual numbers through three quarters. Andre Sirocu leading Panama with 15 points. He's the only scorer in double figures. Daniel Smachore has 7 rebounds and 6 assists for Panama. For Puerto Rico, Yaniel Rivera has 16 points on 6 of 12 shooting. Adir Torres has 10. Jose Melendez has 11, leading rebounder for Puerto Rico. Yaniel Rivera with 6. And Sebastian Rivera with 5 assists. So 10 minutes to play to decide this second game of the first day of competition here at the FIBA U17 Championships in the Central Basket Region. 3 on the way is up and good for Lionel Alba. And the drive there by Reynaldo Pagan. Apologize to the head coach of Puerto Rico, Edin Santiago. I've been referring to him as Cordero. It's his mother's maiden name, of course. Former national team player for Puerto Rico. ...71-59. Inside 9 minutes to play in this fourth quarter. And a travel underneath Yaniel Rivera. With the turnover for Puerto Rico, so Panama again with a chance to cut this lead down to just 10. Alba trying to get it in. Can't, and that's going to be a turnover.
Abby, stop it!
Lob inside, beautiful play as Edir Torres couldn't quite get the dunk, but a beautiful alley-oop. And the lead now back up to 14. Panama with the travel. That was Victor Julio taking a step too many as Puerto Rico now trying to look for the knockout blow. Panama had a chance to get it down to 10. Reynaldo Pagan to inbound. Rivera gets it between a pair of Panamanian defenders, now finally into the front court. 10 on the shot clock. Rivera bodied by Kentish. And the shot clock expires, so that'll be a turnover. So Panama still trying to claw its way back in. Puerto Rico trying for the knockout blow, and now looks like Kentish called for the carry. Puerto Rico to inbound with the 14 on the shot clock. Here's the move by Aviles. He is denied. Back out to Rivera. Long deuce on the way and good. Tough shot there by Yaniel Rivera. The 16-year-old awfully impressive in this game. Gets the lead back to 17 now. Another miss by Panama. Here comes Puerto Rico back the other way. Pagan takes it coast to coast and lays it in with the right hand. The seas just parted for him, and he took it all the way to the rack and laid it in. And Puerto Rico now trying to put away Panama. 77-59, 7:20 to play in the game. Ball poked away as Rodriguez attempted the drive. Puerto Rico will retain possession, 14 on the shot clock. Don't forget, two more games coming up tonight. At 5:30 local time, El Salvador and Dominican Republic. Followed at 8:30 local time by Mexico, the host nation, and Jamaica. Mexico trying to defend its gold medal from the 2019 tournament. And the top three from this Central Basket U17 Championship will advance to the U18 FIBA Americas Championship in June of 2022. Panama calling timeout now as Nicanor Rivas trying to figure out a way to get his team back into this game in a hurry. We're back with fourth quarter action in just one moment. Back to the action here. Fourth quarter, 7:03 to play. Panama turns it over again. Puerto Rico looking to finish off Panama, but Panama comes away with a steal there. Danielle Smatore giving it up to Andres Oroku, his three-pointer too strong. And Puerto Rico loses it out of bounds. Yaniel Rivera has it go off his knee. .647 to play. The lead is 18 for Puerto Rico. Still plenty of time. Busquez now left side to Oroku. He puts a three up. No good. Rebounded by Torres. Yaniel Rivera into the front court. Picked up by Machore. Left side now. And Rivera has it back. Shot clock at 7. Rivera looking for help. Puts up the 3 ball. That's no good. And the rebound grabbed by Machore. He's bumped from behind. And that's going to be a foul on Puerto Rico. Machore into the front court. Juan Lewis skips his way into the lane and then leaves it for Kentish. Kentish, his running hook goes. I beg your pardon, I believe that was Emmanuel Perignon. Saw a 5 on the jersey there. Shot blocked by Perignon. Fighting for it underneath, Alejandro Aviles, and he gets it to go, and he's going to try for the and one. Actually, they're going to say that was a non-shooting foul. The foul was on Oroku. Scoring there for Puerto Rico was Joviel Arroyo. Now Machore on the drive, kicking it out to Busquez. Loses the handle for a moment. And a travel forced by the Puerto Rican defense. Boy, when Puerto Rico decides to turn up the pressure defensively, they make life very, very difficult for Panama. Arroyo left side, now back to the right to Rivera, now into the corner, and no shot. Didn't quite see what happened away from the ball there. A substitution being allowed for Puerto Rico as Jose Melendez comes back on. Now some confusion at the scorer's table here as our FIBA staff will try to get everything all straightened out. Looks like they're going to video replay. Second game of the day here in Mexicali. Earlier, Costa Rica defeated Aruba 93-41. Two more games coming up this evening at 5:30 local time, El Salvador and Dominican Republic. Followed up at 8:30 by the host nation and defending U-17 Central. 24 on the shot clock. Okay. Took us a moment to figure out what was going on exactly there. Wasn't sure if it was something on the floor, and then saw one of the coaches in the replay, video replay, pointing up at the clock. And so our game officials, Ricardo Hales of Jamaica, Bruce Grajeda from Mexico, and Candidate Nu from Dominican Republic, went over and reviewed the video and made sure that the correct time was reset. Now a three on the way from Melendez, no good, and here comes Panama back the other way. Inside 5 minutes to play, Machore getting it to Gonzalez, splits the defenders and goes up with the right hand off the glass. Slick move there by Fernando Gonzalez. Puerto Rico leading by 16. You can bet they're going to use as much time as they can on each possession here. Aviles, low left side, getting it back up top. Shot clock at 7, kick out to Rivera for the 3. That's no good. That looked like it was right on line. And now here comes Panama. Spin move by Machore. Behind the head pass. Three-pointer on the way from Vasquez. No good. Boy, I don't know how Machore wasn't whistled for a travel there. Looked like he took a couple of extra steps. And now the outlet pass by Puerto Rico. Not sure that ever came down. So it's going to be Panama ball, 4:09 to play, trailing by 16 in the fourth quarter. Certainly not an impossible deficit to surmount. Achore goes around the screen, gets it over to Vasquez. Aviles closed quickly, so Vasquez couldn't take the three, and now the shot in the lane by Perignon up no good. And looks like that's going to be a foul called on Panama. Every tick of the clock that goes by for Puerto Rico, they are just fine with that as they try to hold on to this 16-point lead. They led by more than 20. It got cut down to 6 at one point in the third quarter. Now a three on the way, and the ball gets stuck in between the cylinder and the glass there. They signaled that was a three by Omar Benitez, but it looked pretty clearly like his right foot was on the line, but the official, I think, had a little bit better of an angle than I did. Either way, the shot was no good. And a technical foul call. Thought I saw the T signal. Not entirely certain what is going on here. I saw one of the Panamanian players. Clapping enthusiastically, but that didn't appear to be what the situation was. Actually, it looks like the technical foul was assessed on Alejandro Rodriguez of Puerto Rico. Did not see what he did there. And the officials once again going to the video replay. Still not certain what the technical was for. And we're going to see the video here. It looked like Fernando Gonzalez kind of threw an elbow at Alejandro Rodriguez first. I didn't see what Rodriguez's response was, but it looked like Gonzalez bumped Rodriguez first. And I think that's what the officials are trying to review, the sequence of events here, with 3:36 to play. There we get a look. There's the elbow, and there's the retaliation by Alejandro Rodriguez. So it looks like Fernando Gonzalez threw the first elbow, and there's the retaliation by Alejandro Rodriguez. Officials speaking with both benches here, trying to explain exactly what they saw on the video. 3:36 to play in this fourth quarter. Puerto Rico on top by 16. We had a couple of elbows thrown, nothing major. Just a little bit of howdy-do. But an international play. Sportsmanship is expected to be of highest priority, and so the officials wanting to make sure that nothing gets out of hand as Fernando Gonzalez misses the first free throw. So they got Alejandro with the unsportsmanlike. I guess they thought his was more egregious than the elbow thrown by Fernando Gonzalez. His elbow was definitely thrown with a little bit more intent. So the lead now 15, 3.5 minutes to play. Pass tipped by Rodriguez, and the shot clock is going to wind down, and that'll be a turnover by Panama. So again, with a 15-point lead, Puerto Rico just fine with the clock ticking down. Taking their time on offense. Rivera getting it back. Shot clock at 7. Rivera on the drive now. Leaving it underneath and kicked out of bounds. And so Puerto Rico will get a chance to burn 14 more seconds as we are just about at the 3-minute mark of game number 2, quarter number 4 in this 2021 FIBA Centro Basket U17 Championship Tournament. We are in the group play stage. Nice take there by Omar Benitez, scoring with the right hand. Both of our Group A games taking place first, and then Group B will start up at 5:30 local time. El Salvador and Dominican Republic, followed by Mexico and Jamaica at 8:30 local time. Inside 2.5 minutes, jump shot there by Edir Torres, short, and here comes Panama. They're going to try to claw their way back into this one. They better start to do it in a hurry now. And a travel there. I believe that was on Machore. It was. Panama can't have too many more offensive trips where they come away empty-handed. And they're going to need some stops on defense as well. Certainly not out of the realm of possibility, especially with the three-point basket in play. But Puerto Rico will be in no hurry to run its offense here. Rivera getting it to Torres now. Up and in, laid into the glass nicely by Idir Torres. And now we're inside of 2 minutes. The lead is 17, and now things looking pretty grim for Panama. Machore, the three, no good. Vasquez on the follow, hangs in the air, and takes it off the glass and in. Pretty play there by Sebastian Vasquez. Into the front now, front court now is Rivera, being hounded by Machore into the corner. Three-pointer on the way. That's no good by Torres, and a foul underneath the basket. That's going to be on Puerto Rico, so it'll be Panama ball, a minute 29 to play in the game. Wherever you are tuned in from around the Americas or around the world, we encourage you to join us again in a little while, 5:30 local time. U.S. West Coast time in Mexicali, Mexico, for the contest between El Salvador and Dominican Republic, followed up at 8:30 by the host nation and defending U-17 champion Mexico, taking on Jamaica. Vasquez can't spin that one in. Ball tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with Panama. Harlan Gay will have the call on those two Group B games. I'll be back tomorrow morning for Puerto Rico and Costa Rica at 11:30 local time, followed up at 2:30 by Aruba and Panama. Panama now taking timeout with a minute 20 to play. They are down by 15. They're going to need some lightning to strike here. They're going to try to get back in this one, but it's going to be a tall order from here on out. Remainder of the fourth quarter action when we return. Back in Mexicali for the final minute and 18 seconds of game number two of the 2021 FIBA Central Basket U-17 Championship. Vasquez has his inbound pass deflected. Puerto Rico a 15-point lead. And the inbound pass stolen, and you'd think that would have to do it for Panama. Puerto Rico certainly in no hurry. Rivera picked up by Vasquez. Shot clock down to 10. Rivera kicking it out. Here's Sebastian Rivera into the corner now. Back up top to Edir Torres. He pops from 17, and that is good. That's going to be a dagger for Panama. Edir Torres hitting on the 17-foot jumper inside of a minute now, 85-68. Vasquez, high right side, inside to Fernando Gonzalez. Now here's Machore The long two is no good, and fighting for it in the corner and saving it is Sebastian Rivera, and here comes Puerto Rico. Saved inbound by Panama, and ball goes out of bounds. So it's going to be Puerto Rico ball, as you see one of the teams in our evening games filing in. 18 seconds to play, shot clock now at 10, about 6 seconds difference. Rivera on the drive, gives it up. Here's Machore with the right-hand lay-in, and that is most likely going to do it for the scoring on this one. 85-70, Puerto Rico will defeat Panama in game number two of this first day of competition at the 2021 FIBA Central Basket U17 Championship. A strong second half performance by Puerto Rico. They withstood every run that Panama tried to make and came out ahead. Puerto Rico, 53% from two-point range, 35% from beyond the arc, 64% from the stripe. Panama actually out-rebounding Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico with 8 more assists. As you look at some of the individual scoring numbers there, we'll run down all of the scoring here. First for Team Panama, as you watch some of the highlights. Andres Oroku led Panama with 15 points on 5 of 9 shooting. Emmanuel Perignon had 11 points on 5 of 10 shooting, and Daniel Smachore had 10 points on 5 of 12 shooting overall. Sebastian Bosquez had 9. Fernando Gonzalez had 9. Ian Salinas played 5 minutes, 39 seconds, did not score. Jorge Roca played 7-12, but did not score. Hamarabas de Leon played 11-01, did not score. Victor Julio had 3 points. Humberto Kentish had 5. Juan Lewis had 2. Lionel Alba had 6. Leading rebounder for Panama, Daniel Smachore had 9 rebounds, 8 of those defensive. He also had 8 assists to lead Team Panama. So nearly a triple-double by Daniel Smachore. He also had 4 steals. Once again, this is the 2021 FIBA Central Basket U17 Championship from Mexicali. We will be back with our evening Group B games, El Salvador and Dominican Republic at 5:30 and Mexico, Jamaica at 8:30. I'm Craig Feta. Thank you so much for joining us. We will see you in just a little while.